The Pharaohs team of the Military Technical College consists of four groups: Mechanical Group, Electrical Group, Science Group, and Management and Logistics Group. We take into consideration the team requirement skills and the members' development and their ability of doing tasks. In the shown figures, we see the number of skills required from the team member, how he was, how he is, and the development of each member. We fabricated our 17 kilogram chassis from 5 mm aluminum sheet. It is designed to be assembled like Lego without any welding, depending on interference of metal. The body is made of aluminum frame covered with Untitled. Double sheet bogie is used to achieve high strength per unit weight, depending on the area moment of inertia theory. Wheels are centered under the bogie to eliminate torsional stress, and in-wheel motor mounting ensures its safety. Simulation shows that a rocker bogie with torsional bar allows the rover to climb a vertical distance of 40 cm and drop 70 cm. Easy disassembly allows us to pack the rover in a small package for easy transportation. Manufacturing is being done in our college's workshop using CNC water jet machining. Our 6 degree of freedom robotic arm is distinguished by being lightweight, simple in design, easy to manufacture, and modular. It consists of small parts assembled in a way that makes it reconfigurable to control its workspace. Our gripper is designed to be adaptive in order to hold things with different shapes and sizes. Rover control system consists of two main subsystems: low-level controller, which is connected directly to the physical layer, and high-level control, which handles navigation and path planning, while ROS integrates the two subsystems. For system wiring, high power is separated from the low power for the safety of the system. A PCB is used to connect between the microcontroller and motor drivers. For rover control, a PID controller is used to maintain rover heading even in case of failure of any of the motors. Control system is designed with fault tolerance consideration, which enables bypassing some of its components in case of failure at expense of some functionalities. Our navigation process consists of global and local planning systems. The global planning system is used to estimate the distance and the angle between the rover and the target, providing an output heading command for the low PID heading controller by shortest path algorithm, while the local system is used for avoiding the obstacles by direction weighting algorithm, since it finds the best direction relative to the rover's position, so it's independent to the error from the INS. Antenna tracking is used to improve the communication range, and by testing, we achieved a range of 1.5 kilometers with low latency. As for the control station, we can control the rover using any web-connected device, which provides flexible and rapid startup and also provides the driver with feedback of the entire system. We are currently testing the rover's capabilities to achieve the competition tasks. Since all tests must be on board, we depended on experiments that change the color of the reagents, so we decided to get our sample in the form of solution, starting with carbohydrates using Bendix reagent, and protein using Burette reagent, and starch using iodine. Our study of rocks gives us clear indication about the existence of current or extinct life. We are also using a variety of sensors like conductivity, humidity, temperature, pH, and moisture. Respecting non-spill policy, our science box is designed to allow us to make a solution and disperse it in all test tubes, and is also equipped with a mini microscope.